Isn't that just classic? That I am not... Oh, goodness. I love that show. Just the characters are so lifelike. You really care about their well, not all the time, but you care about their situations. Sometimes you intentionally aren't supposed to care about their situations because it's so off the wall. Oh, you didn't get into the wine club today, did you, Niles? And they treat it like a big thing. Oh, goodness. It really does make you forget about your problems and your little issues that you have. And you just kind of lose yourself in this fun little world that seems so real. Wow, playing that sentence back made me sound kind of sad. Goodness. But I just really like Frasier a lot. It's really long, too. It's got, like, 11 seasons. And I think I've gotten to season 9 now. I haven't watched all of them. But I have them on Netflix, and I've watched most of them, and they're gold. So even if the last two seasons kind of stink, which, I mean, for a long-running TV series, you kind of have to expect a dip in quality. But not here. I only get better, right? Because I listen to feedback, and it's new games all the time. It's not just the same concept over and over and over again. No. Even though the last, like, 15 videos have just been slowly dying. But anyway, yes, things are going well here. So even if the last two episodes or last two seasons of Frasier aren't that great, it's really worth a check out, really, guys. I love it. And the other television show that I briefly expressed some love for. Ooh, I have more soda. The other TV show that I briefly expressed a loving interest for is what I consider to be the best television show of the late 2000s. Probably the best TV show. Oh my god. Hold on, I gotta focus. Just a second. I will get in there! No! I got in there! Damn it. 5. I'm so tempted just to put on that ring. I don't need it to beat the boss. I just need it to get across the... I just needed to get across the... No, there aren't many bosses left. It's just Nito, Sif, Gwyn, Calamit. Oh god, I'm taking... You know what? One mulligan. Because of how bullshit this boss is. I will not wear a single ring on the way there. But I'm wearing the ring up until this point. God damn it. This is unacceptable. This is completely unacceptable. Damn it. The dice can be a cruel mistress. Damn. I swear if I beat him, beat this Witch of Izalith, I don't even remember what I have to take on or off. No shield, but I can have my... You know what? Maybe I can go kill Nito. I can't kill Nito. With a club? That's all I have? All I have is a club! This has gone horrible! This has gone awry in the worst possible way. I should have gotten to either of them. I can't even imagine going to kill Sif with just a club. I could. It would be incredibly difficult. You know what? That's what I'm gonna do. If I die here, I'm only getting one chance to fight this Witch of Izalith, and then I'm gonna go and fight Sif, the dragon, at level 1, with just a club. And if I keep rolling an 8, maybe not even with a club. This looks funny. What the heck? What a strange camera angle. This is my only chance. This is such bullshit. I can't even understand how bad this has gotten. That's it. 5 again, as if it needs to rub it in my face anymore. You're so close to being, oh, you know what? You know what? It's a boss in the back pocket. It's a boss in the back pocket. Let's warp out of here. Chamber of the Princess. No, in Orlando. Yes. That's right, everybody. That's right. We're doing this. Not this club, but this club. And I think I can wear pants. I think I can wear pants. What's pants again? Pants is 4. Have I rolled a 4? Potentially. You know what? Just because I can't remember, I'm just going to wear these pants, these golden pants. And if I roll a 4 again, I'll take it off and no more pants. You know what? No, 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 no. Just a club. This is barbaric. This is barbaric. And tough times call for tough measures. I'm getting desperate. But I can do this. I can easily do this. I can conquer the Duke's archives with just a club. And I'll prove it. And I'll do it. And I've got it. I've got nothing but time. I've got at least 2 more hours before I need to stop for today. And I want to get you, Sif. Or Sif. Thesis. Cethus. But in the meantime, while we're running over here, I'll tell you of the show that I think is perhaps one of the best child TV shows of the decade. And probably even of last decade. It's not Star vs. the Forces of Evil, which is a really good one. It's not Gravity Falls, which again is a really good television show. Ooh. That's not even touching my back. You've like popped a zit on my back, you weirdo. I can do this. I just can't get sniped. You just have to fight me. Oh god, I forgot you're there. No. Ooh, thank you, Dark Souls hitboxes. You are an angel. This is the true test of skill. Can a mere barbarian... Oh, he shot me in the crotch! Oh, okay. Oh, what a lovely medieval teabagging I just received. Goodness. Oh, no, I didn't sit! Didn't sit at the bonfire. I thought I did. Oops. Fuck. Okay, at least now I'm running over without pants. Here we go. I am naked. This is the weakest I could be, but then I pull out the club. Then I walk into the club. And I can prove why I'm called the master. Walk slow. And carry a big stick. Tread softly and carry a big stick, so my apologies. Anyway, best TV show, children's television programming, Steven Universe. My goodness, that show has taken me by storm. It is doing things that I have not seen done in a television show for a very long time. It's capturing my imagination, and a lot of imagination of a lot of people. Now, I'm not going to lie and say that, you know, Steven Universe doesn't have some bad press around it. You know, I feel like a lot of people who are first getting into Steven Universe or hear about it, they hear about it as that one show where there's lesbians and they are kind of like sexy, weird space aliens or something. And there's this kid who's kind of annoying and there's a lot of crying, I guess, or something. And they have some songs and something like that. And trying to think a bit of... trying to think about it from a person's perspective again, from a newcomer's... What have I heard about it again? I'm trying to think. It's... I'll admit, it seems really obnoxious from the outside. And I'm not gonna lie, the first, like, 10 episodes... Well, maybe just the first 4. They are obnoxious. They're... It was... I'm not gonna make excuses and say that it was great from the very beginning, because it's not. It was a very rough beginning, I would say. The first episode in particular when I was showing the series off to a friend of mine, I cringed a little bit. There's a kid rapping about ice cream. It's a little bit cringeworthy. But the emotional payoff, and that sounds really funny to say, but the emotional payoff that you get from this show is worth every little bump in the road. It is impeccable. It makes you connect with these characters because it takes a lot of time. It takes a lot of time with itself. It develops these characters and their personalities very particularly, and it throws these curveballs at you that you just don't expect. You think you understand where a kid's show limits itself. This show does so much in so many great directions. Die! And I can't really say too much without spoiling stuff, so you're really just gonna have to trust me. There's a lore and an imagination to this show that I have not seen since Batman, the animated series, honestly. It is really that deep, and it treats you as an intelligent human being and not as a kid. That's why I like Steven Universe a lot, because it's not afraid to tackle some really hard concepts. Parental death is one. Floating books is another. I wish I could wear that as a hat. Fascinating. Teenage angst. How does someone value themselves as a person? Oh god, how did I... What? I didn't die. Hacks. Obvious hacks. Everything should kill me in one hit. Silly. I'm trying to think. Oh, here's a good example of something that I haven't seen in a long time. In a long time in television shows, especially children's television shows. They showed a bare ass. I have not seen bare asses in television shows in a long time. Ever since that one, who was it? Somebody who accidentally slipped their breast out during the American Super Bowl. As if there's a different Super Bowl, but some lady in a performance accidentally let her nipple slip out, and that caused a lot of uproar, a lot of like, whoa, what are the kids seeing live on television? What's going on? I'm freaking out. Kids will know that women have the nipples. How dare they? Ow. Ooh, that guy doesn't know I'm here. I just Metal Gear Solid your ass. Okay. Oh, shit. Run. Back off. We have to be very careful here. These crystal guys. As a matter of fact, you know what? This is the perfect place to talk about Steven Universe, because these people are crystal gems. Ooh. You know what? Here, I'll talk about Steven Universe just a little bit to entrance you. I'm reminded of that Snoop Dogg song. I'm here to entrance you. Now they can't find you. Now they miss you. Where are you? I will hit you, deceive you. Whatever. That one. Skrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrr
Pop it like it's hot, pop it like it's hot. When the pigs try to get at you, pop it like it's hot, pop it like it's hot. That's my very weak Snoop Dogg impression. I can't remember the other ones. I just know, and when the niggas give you attitude, pop it like it's hot, pop it like it's hot. I do like Snoop Dogg quite a bit. It takes quite a bit of personality to just be that ballsy with just your crazy old self. I saw him, I think he was at PAX or something. Snoop Dogg himself was at PAX playing a video game, and there he was, just in the booth. He was hitting up that blunt. You know he was. And they cut to him, and he's just got a spliff right in his mouth. Oh, by the way, I'm not that dumb. Oh, shit. Here we go. Maybe I shouldn't have attacked you. Skrrrrrrr! Oh my god! I thought he grabbed me!
Now they can't find you. Now they miss you. Where are you? I don't know. Because I got high when I killed you. I don't know where the body is. Who would know? I don't know. Go back to Tony for another blow. You know.
I like Snoop Dogg quite a bit. Hey! Skrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrr you jump off of here, but I'm not gonna do that. Let's just, we'll take the hit. Why not? As Snoop Dogg would do, we'll just take that hit. You know how it go. Here we go, here's Tony with the blow. He's gonna go. Let's go, Tony. Skirt! Will I miss you? Will I hit you? I deceive you. I will kill you. We are the crystal gems, don't you know? That's why the people of this world believe in garnet, amethyst, and pearl, and Steven. Don't you know? Anyway, Steven Universe is about this little kid. There's no easy way to say this. He was his mom, now he is him. He was his mom, now he has three moms and a dad. Hello, this is a dragon I need to kill. Hello, I'm a naked lady come to kill you, you butterfly bastard. You killed your own kind, Matt. You would rather have your dragons die than you. Oh, I don't have any, oh, okay. Let's just get this over with. This is a supposed to lose fight. This is, yeah, Dark Souls actually has this. Behold, no matter how much health you have, this is a supposed to lose fight. You're dead. He's rooted himself to the ground. He's gone crazy. But how sane could you have been at the very beginning? Skrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrr Let's go. Here's our jailer, Solid Snake, fallen asleep. The weakest snake in the universe, because you just punch him once with any weapon and he dies. And look, we've got cell companions, everybody. The crystal gems, amethyst, garnet, and pearl. Oh, Pearl, you're my favorite. Anyway, Kid has three moms, Garnet, Amethyst, and Pearl. They are rocks. They are literal rocks that can project themselves as flesh holograms. That's right, flesh holograms. Oh, that's kind of cute. He used his, Oh, that's not cute. I didn't know we were playing Clock Tower. We are. These things, they used to be humans, if you can believe it. If you believe the lore, they used to be humans. Princesses, maidens, captured away and turned into horrible beings. And look, these snake guards, while they might try to kill me, they know what that sound means and they're running away. See, look. They know what that sound means and they know these weird, like, Cthulhu princesses are on their way. Oh my god! How did I... Nope. I'm at the bonfire. Can't you see? I'm at the bonfire. I didn't know you could access the bonfire from there. What the hell? You learn new things every day. Why does your loincloth have cuts in the ass? I'm not gonna ask. I know humans put ass flaps on stuff. Not gonna ask. Well, usually that's because, like, it's so cold we can't take our clothes off and we just shit through a hole in the garment. Anyway. Crystal gems. They're rocks. They're just rocks. They can project themselves as anything. They are holograms, but with skin and bone. And if that doesn't provide you with some nightmare fuel right off the bat, I mean, think about it. Think about it. What could a hologram really project? Think about those 3D images that were really coming up. Oh man, my club is amazing. Amazing. It's locked. That's not amazing. Uh-oh. You guys ain't even shit. You can't even kill me. Okay, you're trying though. You're so pretty. I love the blue of those tentacles. So pretty. If I was into getting, you know, loved by a tentacle, I would want one in that color. Not into that, but I know some people are. And I'm not gonna shame them. No shame for you. You can't help what you like, you weirdos. Anyway. And these three alien crystals try to teach this young fat kid morals and how to use his little powers. He's a half-human, half-alien, which is, again, a very interesting concept because he does not fit into human society or to alien society. What is he? It's the classic tale of the half-breed trying to assimilate into some kind of society, and he's lucky enough to have people that actually do legitimately care about him. And it's a show of dark, dark origin. Not that I'm saying the person who created it had a dark origin, I'm just saying that the more backstory that's revealed about these characters, the more you understand exactly what's happening in their little universe, and how horrible it is that this is the world they live in. As a matter of fact, the creators of the show even acknowledge that what is actually happening in the universe of Steven Universe is darker than anything anybody has theorized. Speaking of dark theories, listen. Can you hear them weeping? Now you can. Let's put them out of their misery. You know, some people might say that it's too cruel. Ooh, I didn't know I could backstab you. Another thing I've learned. Another one. Hey, you're here.
Hello again. What a chance meeting, is it? Alas, I'm in prison once again. I don't suppose you could stage me and get away. The archives. Such a storehouse of knowledge. So close, but just out of reach. The thought offends me so I could sleep. As a student of the arts, you understand me.
I don't know. You wouldn't teach me the arts. I'm sorry, I was too stupid to learn your magical magic.
Really? I didn't know he shows up here if you don't buy his spells from him. I thought he just would stay away. Fascinating. I thought he would just, spend his whole life at Firelink Shrine. Another one! Uh-oh. Oh shit, I almost walked off. Turn off that damn young people music. It'll stop aggravating the princesses. Or the maidens. Yoink! Electricimacy! Well, time to roll it again. That's a six. I'm glad it puts the... it has a little line under the six, just so I absolutely know what it is. Oh. Piss buckets. Whoa, snake. It's not over yet, snake! Man, I need to play Metal Gear Solid for you guys. Two. As long as I don't roll an eight, I'm happy. Oops. I'm embarrassed. Anyway, I need to play Metal Gear Solid for you guys because it's... I know how Metal Gear Solid looks from the outside. I know it looks crazy. Okay, I know that it looks like a whole bunch of old people yelling at each other. And if you really want to know what Metal Gear is, I'll tell you in one sentence. And this is the... I've thought about this a lot. And this is the closest that I can get to describing Metal Gear in one sentence. Metal Gear is a story that was written by Tom Clancy and... Not literally, of course. Sorry, hold on. Let me start the sentence again. Metal Gear is a story that was written by Tom Clancy and Stan Lee on cocaine. That's the best that I can get to explaining what Metal Gear even is. Because on the one hand, you've got a tight, well thought out, fascinating death. Damn. Four, you've got a really well thought out war story. You've got a great one about proxies and soldiers and peculiar dolls. Actually, is there peculiar? I think there's a peculiar doll. It's just... It's a fascinating story of love, loss, hate, friendship, brotherhood, betrayal, It's just got it all, really. It's got everything you could ever want. But then Stan Lee comes in, and there are very uniquely powered individuals that perforate the world. And it's a really interesting little place to... Do you guys attack me? Yes.